Hi and welcome to Danimations Digital Media Tips. In this episode, we're looking at Android smartphones once again, this time at Motorola's Milestone XT720. Now this was a great handset on spec, but like most high-end smartphones, it does draw a lot of power. So I had a look online and I found myself the largest capacity replacement battery I could, and I'm going to show you how to swap that battery out and then talk a little bit about whether it really delivered what it promised to. So first step is to simply power off the phone. So hit power off there. Okay. Now we flip the phone over and remove the battery hatch. Now in here we see the original stock battery that was shipped from Motorola. You see the model number there is BP6X. That's the model number I searched for to find a suitable replacement battery online. And I'll pop that battery out and check out the flip side. On the flip side it says the capacity of the battery is 1,390 milliamps. Now here's the Deji high capacity business battery that I found to use as a replacement. You'll see that its capacity is 2,000 milliamps. Fairly substantial improvement. The case is kind of cool too. It's tin and it reminds me of a primary school pencil case. Maybe something worth repurposing when you're done installing your battery. Now there's a little contact protector, it's a piece of sticky tape there attached to the battery. Peel that off and that will reveal the contacts through which the power passes from the battery to the phone once installed. And in it goes, matching contacts with phone contacts. And replace the battery hatch and power up the handset. The battery will ship with some charge, so you should be straight down to business. So now you've seen the battery installed, you're probably wondering, is it worthwhile? Now, if you're just looking for a runtime benefit, the battery works, no doubt about that. You get more time out of a single charge of your battery. However, the battery meter, at least in Froyo 2.2, which is the operating system I'm running on here, the battery meter simply doesn't understand this battery. So what happens is the meter will tell you that you've used 75% of your battery in a relatively short period of time, while the remaining 25% can take you hours, if not half a day or more, to deplete. Now, this may not sound like a big deal, but unfortunately, things like the camera simply aren't usable when you reach really low capacity on your battery. Also, you'll start to find that you get warning prompts when you open a variety of applications telling you that, oh no, you've got low battery, you better not use it all up by using this application. Very frustrating. So the Danimations roundup on this is, if you're all about power, go for it. But if you want a hassle-free battery, maybe consider an alternative brand. Or you know what, maybe it's time for a different handset altogether.